Hello everyone. Now we will solve one more question on the same radial line method. The question says that a hexagonal pyramid. So pyramid means radial line method. Hexagonal means six sides. So hexagonal pyramid of base is 20 mm, axis height 48 mm, resting on its base on HP such that one base edge is parallel to VP, that is the pyramid. So we will solve it just similar to the previous question. I have solved one question for the development of a square pyramid. In that I have explained each and everything. I have given a model also how we are going to develop the radial line. So here I will directly go for the question. Hexagonal pyramids, top view will be hexagon, one base edge is parallel to VP. So it means we have to take one base edge parallel to XY, and base edge is given 20. So I'm taking 20 base edge parallel to XY like this. Right, so this base edge is parallel to VP. Now we will complete the hexagon. I told you in the hexagon what will be the internal angle, 180 minus 360 by n, n is 6, so I am getting the value 120. So from this side I have taken 120 angle. It is just similar to the parallel line method when we draw the hexagonal prism. So if you have watched all those videos where I am explaining how we can make the hexagonal prism, so I don't think so you will have any confusion in making the hexagonal base. So this is 120. I'm taking the internal angles one by one. I'm taking the next point. So this is again 20, taking the base edge given. Now I will take this point, and again I'll take 120 angle. If you have drawn the parallel line method, if you have solved those questions, I don't think so this will be a problem for you, how to make a hexagon or any polygon. Radial line method is just similar to the parallel line method. Only few differences are there. You have to just take care about those differences. In simple words, if I want to explain, I can say everything what you have done in the parallel line, that you have done in the in a parallel direction, now you are going to make the same thing in radial direction. That is why it is named as a radial line method. So if you compare the two methods, then it will be easy to remember the steps also. So in this way I have prepared the top view of a hexagonal. Now in this, what I have to do, I have to join the opposite corners. In the last video I told you what will be the top view of a pyramid. This is the top view of a prism. So when I have to make the top view of a pyramid, I have to join the opposite corners so that I can get the apex, and this is the edge which is joining the top view with the apex like this. I have, in the last video I have given you one example like this, a square pyramid was there. So when you see the top view, you can see the apex to the base edges. This is a square pyramid, this is a hexagonal pyramid, but same symmetry is there. Now we will do the numbering. Extreme left corner I will start. This is 1 2 3 4 5 6, one base edge parallel to XY or parallel to VP. No need to give the alphabets, only base corners will be there. It will have, when you see from the top view, it will have only the base corner, no top corner, only one apex. So O point is there. Now we will go for the front view. Take the projections from each and every projection. From 6 and 2 overlap, projection from 5 and 3 overlap, and then projection from 4 point like this. Now height is given. What is that? Height is 48 mm. So I told you height will always be from apex. So from the apex I will take the center axis. What is the way to draw the center axis? One long, one short, continuous chain line, 6 mm long line, 1 mm gap, 3 mm small line. So continuous series of that like this. Now height is given 48, so we will do the same. From here I will take the 48 height on apex. So I got this point. Now from this point I will join all the base corners, base points which are there on XY line, so I can make them dark. Like this, then we will draw the base also like this. Then we will do the numbering. So here it will be 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash. Same way how we did the numbering in parallel line method, for prism we are using the same method. So this is the front view and top view of a hexagonal pyramid. Now we will see the development. In parallel line method you have taken gap here, but in radial line you will give the gap here from apex point parallel to the xy line, any gap. So you got this point. After that I told you we have to draw the arc. Now that arc, radius of that arc will be the outermost slant height, but you have to check that is the true slant height or the reduced one. So here O dash 4 dash, outermost slant height, or O dash 1 dash, outermost slant height. So O dash 4 dash in the top view, this is O4. So O4 is parallel to XY, so it means this is the true slant height. This is the way to check is it the true slant height or not. I will give you a few examples of that also, where we will not have this true slant height. How to solve the question in that problem I will discuss. So after taking that radius you have to draw the arc. So we don't know the length of this arc. After that, where it is intersecting with XY line, you have to join it with this. Now why actually we do this? By doing this we will get these two lines parallel to each other, right? So this is your start point one. After that you have to take six faces. What you did in the parallel line method, you have taken the one base edge, any base edge size, and you have taken the same six surfaces in parallel line. Here you will take the same but in radial line. So it means you are going to cut this 1 2 3 4 5 and one more 6, right? Now we are going to join it, means you have to join them like this. Point will be joined with apex. You can make it dark because after that we have no need to do the sectioning or whatever, so you can initially make it dark. We will solve few questions also where we have to cut this object. In that case we have to make them dark after sectioning, means in those we will make the light diagram, and later on we will make the dark portion, what will be the remaining part, same like what we did in parallel line method. Now we will join these edges also. It is just similar to the previous question, means when a square pyramid is there, its base edges will be the straight line. So that is why we are joining them like this. After that you have to give the numbering. This is 2 3 1 2 3, this is 4 5 6, and again the point is 1. So this is the development. This is the front view, top view. It is just similar to, I'm giving one example of this square pyramid. When you cut and open, so it will have the straight edges, right? So same we did it, straight edges. So after that we will do the dimensioning. Give dimension to any one base edge. No need to give the angle of this hexagon, only we will give the one base edge. So it is given over there, that is 20. Now axis height we have to give. Axis height is also given, so we have the axis height, that is 48. Right, now this is the front view, this is the top view, this is the development of surface. But before that I will give you the high dimension of this part, means this radial length, and I'll give the dimensioning of this also. Like this. So this is the slant height. We don't know the length of this. We will measure and then we write the dimension. So when I measure, it is coming equals to approximate 52. So I'm taking that 52 here. After that I have to give the dimension of this radial path also. So what I'll do, just in the same way, open the compass more than that size like this, and draw the arc up to the extension line on that end, and then I have to give the arrowhead. This is actually the way how we represent the length of this curve. So this is again end into B, that is what, six number of side each having size 20. So this is what, 120, and this is what, development of surface. So we write it like this: development of surface. So this is the solution of the same question, a hexagonal pyramid.